oli me koko ajan YouTubessa. Ennen kuin me rääkkisimme. Aika selvästi oli kyllä muuta. Mulle ei jopa kaikki. Saimme ka telekkaa.
So, ladies and gentlemen, let us start with our last session. And the next speaker will be Evert Raatsen, an old friend of our school and Estonia. Evert has received his pilot education in Netherlands, Dutch Air Force, and then he continued his aviation career in Sweden. Business Jet Flight Center Sweden AB, Swedair AB, Bromma Flying School, he was CEO and shareholder, Scandinavian Aviation Academy, and Scandinavian AirTech AB, also representation of Cessna Aircraft Company. Evert has been active at the revival of our pilot education in the early 90s at NO High School and later on at Tartu Aviation College. So, Evert, will you be so kind and take the floor?
Thank you, Hans. Do you hear me? Is it on?
Yes.
It is on. Okay. Good afternoon, everybody. It is nice to be back here in Tartu, where it all started a long time ago. And Hans asked me to talk about the past. Now, at my age, I can talk about the past for a day, for a week, or whatever you want. But you're lucky because Hans, he put a time limit on it. Only 15 minutes, he said. That will be enough. So, this is not a presentation. Ah, there we are. I want to go back. There we are. Back to the future. When we started in the 90s, we were not thinking about the present. We were only thinking about the future. And this is not a presentation of facts, figures, or graphs. This is a presentation about a story about dedicated people in Estonia with the same aim and willing to work very hard to make a new future for Estonian aviation. You must remember, times were totally different. The younger ones sitting here, you have no idea how it looked in Estonia 25 years ago. It was a totally different world. So, the reason I'm saying is because this is the most important thing that happened. In those days, there were people that were dedicated. They wanted something. They wanted to start a new future for aviation. And I'll show you the people that were there in the beginning. The story starts in 1991 and it ends in 1994, when the flying school, which is today Packer Aviation, Packer Avio, was self-supporting. But in the meantime, in 93, Tartu Aviation College was formed. And after that, we continued our cooperation. And I'll show you pictures of what we did. So I'll rush you through the story because there are hundreds of pictures and things I want to tell you, not today. Oh. Too many knobs. Okay. what happened in 1991, that the Swedish CIA called me and said, Everett, the four people at the Arlanda airport, they want to look at a flight school. Can you arrange that? I said, sure, I can arrange that. So jumped in the car, drove to Arlanda, and there I met 50% of the Estonian CIA. Three people. And the three people, they were Matti Sermus, Rein Porro, Otto Tauer, that all of you of course know, and Ilar Link, he was associated with that. It was already a little bit late in the afternoon. I said, we're not going to the flying school, we go home to me, we sit and discuss, you know, and that's what we did for some hours. And they were very clear in their message. We don't want anybody to come to Estonia to train our pilots, we want to do it ourselves, you know. We don't want send our pilots to another country, that's not the idea. We need support and help to start a flying school in Estonia. So that's what we discussed, that was explained, there was already a start at the no secondary school where people had started training. So next day we visited the Bomber Flying School and we gave them all the works, we showed them the airplanes, our syllabus, how we worked and things like that. And then, very interested, we pointed out, we work in close cooperation with SAS, Linjeflug, and those that's important for a flight school. And then we agreed to make a presentation in Tallinn later this year. Then we were invited to come in December 1991. See, I hit the right button. And I can assure you, in 1991 was years before Jan Tam and his free rotating airspace, you know, because you can see here, if you wanted to fly to Tallinn, you had to fly to Helsinki, land, pick a telephone, call to Tartin and say, we're in Helsinki now, when can we come? Yeah, call back in 20 minutes. Okay, call back in 20 minutes and then you can arrive then and then. Straight route, do not go left or right, straight route. And that's when we landed in Tallinn and we gave a presentation for people of the representative Department of Transport, Department of Communication, aviation companies, journalists and so on. And we told them about Bromma. Now this goes very quickly, because Bromma Flying School started in 1963, and almost every year something was happening, and is still happening today. When I'm not speaking, you can read yourself, okay? Good. So, these are just the main things. 1967 was the first commercial pilot operation, education in together with Scandinavian Airlines and Linjeflug, the domestic airlines. 1980, we started the new training syllabus of integrated training program in ICAO Annex 1, and then in 1984, we were the first flight school in Sweden to be authorized to perform the modern and integrated ab initio pilot training. And you see, in 1987, we did transition of military pilots, over 100, to civilian pilots for SAS. And in 88, we did commercial pilot training commissioned by for Linjeflug. They would ask if we had 25 students, can they all come and work for us? We said, sure, you know, if they want to. 1998, and that's an important year, was the new ab initio commercial single engine and instrument training according to ICAO requirements. Now that is important because that is the year we came to Tallinn to make our presentation. So this is obviously the kind of training you want to have in Tallinn. We showed our airplanes and instrumentation. This is Cessna 210, this is Cessna 340 for the twin engine. And a lot of this instrumentation and navigation equipment was quite different as what the pilots were used to. They were flying Yak 52. Next day, we were flying to Tartu. Now, that was not so easy as you think, because before we could take off, we had to take a Russian interpreter on board. So he would translate what we would tell to ATC. Again, times were quite different in those days. We met at Tartu. We showed our airplanes. We looked at the facilities. We met the people from the NO High School. This is the 340 at Tartu. Here are the people I'm talking about when I'm talking about the dedicated people who are willing to work very hard, have the same aim to achieve something, start a new pilot education in Estonia. So this is a picture. We were invited in the evening to have dinner at the NO High School. Together with all the students was very nice. We met many of them, talked what did they want in life and so on. Next day, after looking at facilities, hangars, where could we educate, where could our people live, you know, we went back again the same way as we came. NO High School. Yes, we also made a shorter flight in a Yak 52, just to get some idea about the training. Okay. Then nothing happened for a little while. This picture is taken by Johannes Tilk, one of the mechanics that came for training in Sweden. He was a good photographer. The picture really only symbolizes all the flights we were doing, fours and backs in January, February, and so on. And for discussions with the CAA, with the aviation people, and so on. The man there in the black suit, he I met about every week or something, and we discussed exactly how we're going to put this on. So the good thing is now, Jan, we had our GPS, so we would go straight from Bromma to Tartu, you know, that helps. So this went on for several months, and slowly it became all in Estonia. Well, life isn't always easy. You can have a flying school, but what rules and regulations are you going to follow? The old Russian ones? Estonian rules and regulations? They were not in place yet. Swedish regulations in Estonia? Not very likely. So it's the same as the maintenance of the airplanes, you know. We need a training syllabus. It has to be approved by the CAA. Now, Ryan Poro, I'm pointing at him again, who's a very practical man. He solved the problem quickly. He took our training syllabus from the school. Do you remember that, Ryan? Yes. And then he translated it, changed it a little bit, and put it into Estonia, presented it to the Estonian CAA, and it was accepted. So now we could really get to work. In June, between June 28 and June 22, the first instructors came to Sweden to be trained. A theoretical training, mechanical training, and all of the instructors would fly a minimum of 6 hours in our airplanes, so to get used to them. Again, picture of the dedicated people. Okay, these are the ones we are talking about. Most of you will probably know or recognize all these names. Okay, here we have theoretical training in the class with our school chief. Here they are out on the apron, practical training with our instructors, pre-flight training, and so on. And of course, the mechanics that were trained at our Bromma facility in our maintenance hangar here. You see Yuri and Johannes and what's his name? The translator, Kai Wirvis, the translator from the CAA, and our mechanic Barver. He worked here in Estonia for quite a long time. Okay. You can't read this, but this is a page of the Tartu prevalent posthumes from the 2nd of July 1992, where it says that on Monday, that's June 29, 6 airplanes arrived at the Tartu airport from Sweden during, I'll just tell you very quickly, during